Welcome back, folks, to another week of Word of Mouth, talking mental health, relationships, careers, etc., etc. Y'all know the deal. Like and subscribe to the channel. Link down below to all our social media platforms. So I didn't post last week, so this week you get guys are getting double whammies. I'm moved for clinicals for the next year or so. So yeah, kind of excited about this journey. You know, it's going to be something different, something interesting. See where things go and whatnot. This probably won't be my permanent place for a year, but you know, I had to find something for the time being until I can get situated and know my lay of the land, so to speak. But let's get into the topic. So this was sent to me last week, I saw it on social media a couple weeks ago, where these individuals were making fun of this boy about his hair, and I wasn't gonna make a video about it because it just didn't seem like it made a lot of sense to make a video. Like, well, I don't say they were making fun of him, but it was, well, the mom was doing the boy's hair online on the live. You know, apparently that's like a lot of money in that, or that's where the way the kid makes the income. And people were making crude comments, and the mom wouldn't stop the video. And I was like, well, if you see they're making your son cry, then go ahead and stop the video, regardless if it's making you money or not. Like, nobody wants to see a child crying because in that situation. And it's like, and the child's like, well, why do they keep calling me a girl? Why do they keep calling me a girl? I'm a boy, I'm a boy, I'm a boy. And I'm gonna play the video so people get to know exactly what I'm talking about. So here goes the video.
We went live and this happened.
Ignore them. They're miserable people. They have nothing better to do than to get on the internet and make fun of people because it makes them feel better about being miserable creepies. Okay? What do we say in the mirror every morning? I am strong. Say it. I am enough. I am handsome. I am perfect just as I am. I am intelligent. And I exude positivity. Sorry, baby. That one got stuck!
Alright, so there's the video and whatnot. So, as you can see, it's kind of, it's not really graphic, but hard to watch that a mom would allow the child to sit through that type of verbal abuse from people and not do anything about it. So that's weird within itself. But a recent update, as in of a few days ago, come to find out that the child was biologically born a girl, but the mom has been referring to her as a boy her entire life. Let me go ahead and say this. It is weird to be discussing child sexuality in any type of regard. It is weird. It is pedophilia-like to even put that situation on a child, because I don't understand why it would matter to anybody the child's gender, because the child is a child. Like, that shouldn't even be a conversation amongst anybody. And I don't care what anybody says, it is weird to discuss that. Now, children do have imagination. They do feel things and whatnot. And if the child presents that to you, fine, cool. You deal with it how you deal with it in your personal home. But to implicate your child with that is a very dangerous thing, mentally, physically, and emotionally. Let's go by mentally. So this girl, I'm going to refer to her as a girl simply because she had no idea that she was born a girl, because obviously she doesn't know what genitalia looks like on a man or a woman. She just knows her. This girl has been convinced that she's a boy since she was a child based on her mother's wants or needs. So when it comes to discovery, she goes to a doctor, she goes to, gets older or whatnot, and she realized, like, nah, you are not a boy, you're a girl, you've always been a girl your entire life. That's gonna mess up a child's psyche from top to bottom, because their whole world is gonna be warped. They may think something's generally wrong with them from, well, I'm a boy and I like boys, I don't think that's okay. But no, you're a girl that likes boys, so that's okay. Even if you refer to her mom, who seems to be lesbian in the group, is like, well, she likes girls and likes girls, it's okay if I like girls too. But that's for one. For two, you put your child in a dangerous physical position because she spends her entire life thinking she's a boy and she's a girl. And then that's it. This is just life. She goes into a situation where boys realize she's a girl. Now they're attracted to her. Now they want to do things to her, etc. and so forth. And she thinks that's weird because, well, I'm a boy, why would you be attracted to boys? And now you put her in a situation where she can be abused in some type of way. So there goes the mental and physical abuse that can come with that. And honestly, I think child services need to come into that situation. That's my own opinion. For two, you never gave her a choice or an option. You just dictated what you wanted her to be without her even knowing what she actually is, which is also dangerous to the mind as well. And then you did it based on your own emotions or opinions. Because for a woman, or anybody for that matter, to push the idea that their child's the opposite gender just means you were not okay with the gender you got as a child and you wanted a different gender. And or grooming them for whatever reason you're grooming them for. But more so, you, what it says, speaks to me is that from the mom is that I wanted a boy, so because I didn't get a boy, I'm going to make you a boy, regardless if people like it or not. Which is terrible. And I think the father of the child needs to step in and not allow any of this, wherever the father of the child is. Or maybe maybe you wanted a boy from the man, you didn't get the boy, and the man doesn't want to deal with you anymore, so you forced that upon that. And that is a very psychotic thing to do. I don't care what anybody says. It's very psychotic to put that type of implication on a child that doesn't have much free will to begin with, and they have no idea or understanding of the world. And for those people, like I said, who like commenting on sexual behavior and all that, and even boy or girl, regardless, making the comments that y'all made, y'all not right for that either. What you making comments about a kid for? It doesn't matter. It's not your kid. Why does it matter if the hair is long, short, or whatever? It's a child. They don't know. Most children maybe don't know the difference between gay, straight, and all that. They don't know all these different acronyms. They barely know if they're a boy or a girl. Clearly. These same kids that, you know, don't know if they're a boy or a girl will want to be a Power Ranger someday. Or a Pokemon trainer. Or a princess. Well, the princess thing is that's impossible, but you get the point I'm trying to make. So that's all I got to say about this. Like, there needs to be something to be put in place where, like, to see if a parent or parents are medically inclined to even be capable of taking care of kids by themselves, because this is going to be an implication of a lot of traumatic things to happen for this child in the future. But that's all I got to say about this. Like and subscribe to the channel. This is Word of Mouth. Peace.
Mm.